الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، one of the most important things that we can remind one another of after Tawheed, and which is a part of Tawheed, is seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Istighfarullah. Istighfar. And I thought it would be beneficial to benefit from this great Imam, Imam Salih bin Fawzan, hafidhullahu ta'ala, one of the kibar ulama, a beneficial treatise entitled Fadl al-Istighfar, the benefits of istighfar, the benefit of istighfar, or the virtue of seeking forgiveness from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Because all of us commit sins, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam said, "Kullu ibn Adam khata, wa khayr al-khata'in tawabun." All the children of Adam commit sins or mistakes, and the best of those who make sin and mistakes are those of the tawabun, those who seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who repent to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Because if all the people make sins, who are the best from amongst them? Because no one can escape then of this trait, madhmum. But this is from our fitrah, this is from our nature, that we commit sins and that we have acts of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a way out, tabarak wa ta'ala, and that is seeking forgiveness and tawbah. Imam Fawzan said, "Servants of Allah, have taqwa of Allah, and know that indeed Allah has ordered us to repent to Him and to seek His forgiveness from our sins in many ayat in His noble book. He is called and described Himself as the All-Forgiving, the Forgiver of sins, and the Possessor of forgiveness. And He has praised those who seek forgiveness and has promised them a great reward. All of these matters show the importance of seeking forgiveness, its virtue, and our need of it. Allah conveyed to us about His prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam, that they sought forgiveness from Him and they turned to Him. He also mentioned the two parents, Adam and Hawa, alayhim salatu wasalam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, 'Our Lord, we have wronged ourselves, and if You do not forgive us and have mercy upon us, we will indeed be from the khasirin, we will be of the losers.'" So, ahabatifillah, that shows us that even the prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam, they sought istighfar. So none of us is above this most glorious and righteous traits, and using this tool and this weapon of the believer, along with dua, along with adhkar, and a part of those adhkar, and a part of those dua, is seeking istighfar. So seek istighfar from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, and we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.